I'm right here in London Fashion Week backstage at Paul Costello's show.
Amanda, we've just come out of Paul Costello's show. What did you think?
I love Paul Costello. I used to walk in his shows when I was a model.
Wow.
Many, many, many moons ago. But this is one of the strongest collections of his that I think I've ever seen.
Yeah.
So strong, so beautiful, so flirty, so girly, and just so elegant. I really, really loved it.
And what was it like when you were walking for him all those years ago?
It was, do you know what? I always remember then. He was obviously doing really, really well, but I always remember thinking, this guy's going to be massive. There was John Rocha and there was Paul, and you thought, these are special shows. I
own the world, we own. Paul, what an amazing show. How do you feel after that?
Well, I'm glad it's over.
Yeah?
Never fully satisfied.
Like, really?
Like, I'm a perfectionist, and it's something that I'm still sort of looking for, and that's what keeps me going.
The choice of material is so important.
Yeah.
And the material here, you've got shamrocks, you've got gorgeous colours. It's really Irish, isn't it?
It was unintentional. The colours are of the season. Orange is in. This is the year of the designer, I gather. So I hear from back home.
Yeah.
So, but it wasn't particularly planned. It was just the richness and the texture.
Talk about the inspiration. So it's all really flirty, very feminine, but it's very sophisticated.
Yeah, there's a mixture of a couple of areas. You've got the Tudors with those very big mutton sleeves and their cutaway shapes, those tent shapes, which look brilliant with those boots, which are great, those
I gotta get me a pair of those, they're beautiful.
They're great, and the knee highs, they look over the knee, look really great. And then I had my long, really long coats, those Russian coats, which was again inspired by, you know, those Russia, pre-revolution Russia.
Mm.
So there were sort of moments in history then at the kind of 50s, full 50s skirts. Mm. It was definitely a collage of fashion shapes in beautiful fabrics.
Definitely. And do you know what I love about you as well? A lot of your stuff, it's affordable, but then as well, you also dress royalty. So you kind of go from right up at the top to kind of, you know, normal people who can afford this, affordable pieces.
It's very nice of you to say that. Yeah. Thank you very much.
And is that important to you, that it can kind of transcend everybody?
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, absolutely. Well, I'm from Dublin. I'm married to a north side. I'm from the south side. I don't feel privileged to dress anybody. If they want to wear something that's nice, they better look good in them, but I'm going to work on it to make them look good. But it's a challenge. I'm not going to step down until somebody tells me, look, you're producing collections that are too old, then it's time to go. No.
But is there anybody, I suppose, that you'd actually love to dress at the minute? I heard you wanted to get a suit for Enda, or help him pick out a suit for Enda Kenny.
Well, I want to dress, honestly, I'm not really a socialite. I'm not a celebrity follower. I don't hold any desire to be anything special. I'm as special as anybody else.
Well, I have to say, I'm completely blown away with your designs. They're absolutely beautiful.
Thank you so much
for talking to us.
Thank you for talking to me.
Thank you.